I'm not going to be playing multiplayer campaign alone. That doesn't make any sense. So with me today, I have the man returns. It's Radoslav. Hello.
Hello again. I'm back again this week so we can continue our campaign. Yeah, we should probably remind people we're playing a head-to-head campaign as Hector of Troy and Paris of Troy, the two sons of King Priam. I think we're 17 turns in, if I remember correctly.
Yes, 17 exactly. I ended up getting quite wrecked at the end of last session by having some enemies run around and raise my homestead. Which means that I'm quite far behind on Priam's air mechanic. Let's see, they want 63 stone a turn, which is more than half of my stone for wood. I need wood. Sure, Achilles, why not? Let's be friends for a bit.
This is one of the interesting things of about multiplayer campaigns is that campaigns play out very differently when there's two players instead of the, you know, usual one player.
Yeah.
Like the AIs just react differently when there's, you know, more players around.
Why would I trade stone for wood? So I, because I was getting wrecked by the AI, a lot of my settlements have actually been leveled down, so I'm in great need of wood right now. Like, as you can see, I have a lot to repair and upgrade. And if we go and look at Priam's air, it's looking really bad for me. It's not great.
You still have opportunities to catch up. The race is actually quite long, so it allows for, you know, sudden turns and comebacks and various other things.
Yeah, absolutely. Oh, here we go. So you want to attack Phineas here. Phineas actually thinks that this is quite an even battle.
It does appear that way, and we're just gonna auto-resolve this one very quickly because there's nobody inside, just a garrison. I'll probably have to fight the next one though, because it appears to be a fair bit more difficult than this one. Mm.
Do you share victory conditions?
We kind of share victory conditions in head-to-head. One of the ways to win, and the easier way to win, is to defeat the other player. Or alternatively, you can choose to... how do I say this? You can fulfill the condition of raising a set number of settlements before the other player does. Mm. So that's also an option. And we have a battle on our hands.
Ooh. I'm gonna spectate. Just to start off with, I'll fight later.
They got the jump on me. I expected to be the one to attack them, but I apparently misread the movement a bit. One of the issues I'm probably going to face in this battle is that due to campaign effects, my general has a slightly lower motivation in campaign, so he gains rage slowly in battle, or slower than usual. Wow. So that might... put me at a disadvantage, because if I don't gain rage, I can't use my abilities, which kind of makes it harder to stack Aristea, and it's generally not ideal. So I'm just adopting a defensive position here, since they attacked me.
Yeah. You defend here. Oh, I love that you can draw on the map. It's like one of the more fun things in life, is just drawing on maps.
Yep. Even if you're spectating, it's still... You can be like, haha, you're losing here.
Yeah. Be like, hey, have you seen this guy? I think he's very important. And I kill him and I think you win. This fight the champion.
Oh, my hero is under attack. Well...
He's in the middle of things, so that makes sense. There we go. Yeah, I got a good amount of damage on those slingers there. Both... The bowmen and the renowned slingers have now turned 90 degrees. No, wait, those are just the slingers. Turn 90 degrees to attack the swordsmen, who are not taking a lot of damage from the slingers there. So the skirmishers are now out of ammunition. Fortunately, you seem to have dealt with all of their range. So now it's just infantry versus infantry here.
I seem to have the better position on them right now. Although my general is routing, which is... It's not ideal.
No, definitely not. He's just broken, though.
It's looking likely he's gonna come back.
Yeah, if you can pull him back, use his buffs a bit, you should be able to do this. Ooh, it looks like you're gonna win this. They are definitely breaking, shattering all over the place. Their front line is gone. Yours is still here. You still even have some ammo on some of those light skirmishers. Not bad.
Yep, I got almost the complete surround on the enemy forces, which worked out better than expected, honestly.
Yeah.
Even if my surround was just some light skirmishers with no ammo, they still managed to inflict some morale penalties.
Paris of Troy. Cool, love's duty. There is only one love in my life, and it is Helen, so I'm gonna refuse the ring.
Yes, the epic mission chain for Paris is really interesting because it tells the story of, you know, it has elements of what Paris was up to before meeting Helen and subsequently stealing her. Okay, this looks like it's a complete and utter rout for the enemies here. Yes, the army full of axe chargers is not that great in a frontal confrontation.
Who would have guessed that this brilliant army comp did not work out? What was it, 20 axe chargers? Oh, 19 axe chargers and one hero? As a Swede, I kind of understand this mentality. Have you ever heard of the crown ship Vasa? There was a king that ordered a new ship. And as the shipbuilders were building the ship, he said, add more cannons. And then he said, add more cannons. And then time went and he said, add more cannons. And you know, the shipbuilders went, but we can't. The ship is going to be unstable. And he said, add more cannons. And so they added more cannons, and it sailed 1,300 meters before sinking.
That's not a lot of distance.
That's so sad.
And apparently we're going to have another battle, because Yep, you're the host, so you can override my decision.
I didn't realize I could override you. I'm sorry.
Yep. It's a part of the privileges of the host.
That was, whoops. Priam's heir. I have caught up very much. I believe a lot of it is because I've been fighting people that you are at war with as well.
Yeah, you have a breakdown on the left, basically, where it came from, what kinds of things you fulfilled. So you've got a lot of points from ensure population happiness, fulfilling destiny.
I might actually be overtaking you soon.
Yeah, that's what I said. I was ahead by some, I don't know, 250 points, but you caught up in no time. I'm just going to spectate. This looks pretty doomed. I don't know, I just feel like unless there's a high-ranked general on the other side, Paris is just... he's quite powerful in such fights. Oh, the enemies are actually just getting decimated on the reinforcement point. How unexpected.
It was
like how Paris shot him like 3 times and he lost a quarter of his health.
I wanted to build up enough rage so I could do a pulse aim on him, but I don't think that's gonna happen.
Yeah, he looks pretty dead to me at this point. He's left with like, I don't know, a fifth of his health or so.
There we go. Apollo's aim. Can we get a finishing shot here on Hippodamus?
I think he blocked it with the shield, but he still took a lot of damage.
Oh, nope, he's dead. Paris.
Yep, and they broke. Although you're starting to get skirmished on the other side as well. There's some renowned archers and slingers that are assaulting you. This seems to be quite the sound strategy coming out from the AI. They did let you shoot them a bit, but, you know.
A bit.
Well, you killed like 2 units. That's a bit, if you ask me.
And one of their heroes.
We're not going to talk about the guys that came as reinforcements. They were just not lucky.
End battle. Woo!